Breaking news, Harvey Weinstein, once Hollywood's most powerful man, has been found guilty of rape and sexual assault by a New York jury.
The disgraced movie mogul was handcuffed and taken into custody, where he now awaits sentencing, which could see him spend decades behind bars. Entertainment reporter Sam Rubin joins us now from Los Angeles. Sam, good morning to you. This signals just the beginning of the end for Harvey Weinstein, doesn't it? He's set to face even more charges.
He faces significant charges again in New York, here in Los Angeles, and potentially in the United Kingdom as well. I think for many, this wasn't enough. He was only convicted of two of the five charges, and some of the most serious charges he was not convicted on. However, for others, this is the beginning of the end, the final fall for a man whose abhorrent behavior and arrogance has finally caught up with him. And you're seeing that reaction, I think, from many in the entertainment community.
Now, this jury, I think there's seven men and five women. They've taken 5 days to deliberate and come back with their verdict. Has there been, in a sense, as this dragged on, that he was perhaps going to get away with this?
I think, Ali, that fear sort of existed, because one thing that happened is after these assaults, some of the parties continued to communicate with Harvey Weinstein and or spend time with him. So the idea is, you know, and I'll use the most layman's of terms, gee, if this took place, why would you ever spend another moment with him? Or was there a transactional nature in the relationship the two of you had? So I think that did have many people quite concerned. But one thing that the prosecutors made very, very clear is that there's a complete distinction between, I don't know, agreeing to attend a cocktail party with someone and sexual assault or rape. And these people, at least two, the jury felt were clearly, one was a victim of sexual assault, the other a victim of rape.
Sam, I would imagine inside LA at the moment, inside Hollywood, the ramifications are pretty far-reaching. I mean, everyone, he's been out of the loop for a little bit of time, given that he's been waiting for all these legal proceedings. But for a long time, for many, many years, anecdotally, everyone knew that this was how Hollywood worked. But does this put a stop to it?
I don't know, Carl, if it puts an absolute dead stop to it. But I think the real distinction here is, for the longest time, and I was aware of this myself, people thought, oh, Harvey Weinstein is a quote-unquote skirt chaser, a guy who likes to have this kind of behavior. But I don't think people realized that it crossed a particular line, that it wasn't just aggressive flirtation, that it was actual assault and rape. You would have to think, between Harvey Weinstein, the toppling of Les Moonves, the head of CBS, all of Ronan Farrow's work, that this kind of behavior, which I think was epidemic, has certainly been curtailed, if not entirely eliminated.
If Weinstein cops the maximum sentence, which would be 29 years in jail, I mean, that's a very long time. Have we heard anything from his legal team yet, whether or not they're going to appeal this conviction?
The legal team has said, Ali, that they will appeal. The legal team also says that he will be in custody now in a medical facility, so that may be the jail ward or jail section of a hospital. I suspect he will be, but I mean, this is. I don't want to say dark necessarily, but he's definitely under stresses and pressures he's never been under. One attorney, which I thought was an unusual remark, said he took the sentence like a man. We will see what happens. But I think the idea, particularly with these other cases, you know, he's going to try to stay out of custody while he fights all these other battles. I think something that Harvey Weinstein never, ever imagined, that he very likely could be behind bars for the rest of his life, is now literally staring him right in the face.
Do you reckon it does, Sam? Do you reckon it doesn't? You live and breathe Hollywood. Do you reckon it does change things, given the fact that men are still very much in power, in charge of the big studios over there in Hollywood? They run a large percent of the actual city and their business itself. Does it actually change something when men have the power to I guess, make or break careers? Does it change that, and will it change it moving forward?
I tell you what, I think there are enough cautionary tales with high-profile executives that men are cautious now. That, in other words, this kind of what I'll describe as sort of flirtatious and initially, you know, schoolyard-like behavior is definitely curtailed, because you do not want your name on the other end of a lawsuit. You don't want your name in the Hollywood trade papers as being investigated by. What happened before is those things would happen, and the men would always win. The investigation would go away. Nothing would happen. The lawsuit would somehow dissipate. You're seeing now concrete results. Harvey Weinstein to jail for criminal activity and Les Moonves, who was every bit as powerful, literally removed from his job.
I do wonder from this if Harvey Weinstein is thinking right now or gets that there was anything wrong with his behavior, or if he still thinks he's the victim in all of it.
Well, I tell you what, given certain press interviews, Ali, that he has given recently, he portrays himself as a victim and said, you know, quote unquote, these were all, I think there was an ongoing sort of transactional casting couch kind of thing where he had activities with people who were likely willing if the reward was good enough. But what he had the inability to distinguish was those who were willing and those who were unwilling. And the unwilling have now spoken up. You know, 90 women have made this claim. So that's a, you know, an extraordinary number.